Okay, no time for intros. This is simply what we are now calling Full Power Extra, where we literally go for 10 minutes and that is it. 10 minutes. I'm about to hit the start button as soon as I say we're going in, okay? So,
should I have a visual clock?
Kai, I could maybe. Ooch, back again once again. This is proof. We literally just came from the movie theaters to see Promare, and this is our review, reaction, thoughts, everything in 10 minutes. Done. Okay? It's going down right now. That movie was fire.
It was literal fire. Like, it was the soul. It was the heart and soul of fire.
I was not expecting to see half.
You invited me to this movie, and I knew it was dubbed. I didn't know the story. I didn't know anything. I knew it was nothing. It was something animated. It was dubbed, and I was like, "Yeah, sure, let's go. Let's check it out." Wow! What a day.
Listen, I was not ready for literally, like, cause not gonna lie, I do vaguely remember seeing promotional stuff for it, like visuals and whatnot, like through the fall season, but
I never even heard of it,
dude. I didn't think it was going to hit me like this. Promare, look, the puns are going to still be rolling. It's fire. It's fire. It's literally a show. It's a movie that the theme is fire based.
Yeah. It's a mecha type of,
it's got animated
movie. Yeah, it's got like the main fighting is happening like in, you know, like mecha robots and whatever, but it's literally about racism.
Low key.
In a way, they really fight, like they classify humans based on regular humans and these people that they call the Burnish that have the ability to control fire. But the fire is actually, spoiler alert, the fire is actually a soul of beings from another dimension that kind of got like linked in with this earth. And the earthlings that resonate with that, the fire souls, became one, and now these humans can control that fire.
It was the story behind that, the concept, that was such a brilliant idea.
It was really good.
Like I said, I was not like, okay, when the opening scene happened and they had like, you know, the first initial like action sequence, like to set the mood or set the tone of the movie, yeah. I was like, oh, okay, this is nice. Like, I could rock with this. Like, the main character, he's cheesy, but you know, we got a lot of cheesy main characters, you know?
Yeah, that's pretty true.
Had a cool hairdo, you know what I'm saying? Got the blue ching ching going on over here. Oh my okay? God. And he was saying everything. He almost felt like he was almost like a Power Ranger or a Tokusatsu character. And guess what? They got mechs. And I was like looking at this guy. I was like, bro, they got Megazords.
Yeah, you said.
I was like, yo, they got Megazords. Facts. I'm in it. Like, I was in it. And then they incorporated fire with it. And then that's when I started making all these calls. I was like, okay, you see this dude, the All Might head ass looking guy. That's going to be
We both agreed on that on my head ass.
He's going to be the plot twist. He is actually the villain of the show. And then they start, and then they're fighting against the Burnish, right? And before they even started speaking, I said, if one of these dudes is Johnny Young Bosch, it's over. Lo and behold, it is the year of the J.Y. Bizzle.
Yo, it really fucking is though. Like how?
He got to voice the coolest character in the movie. The coolest character in the movie.
And he sold it, as he sells everything. He's
the first word he said, I heard it. I was like, I looked at you. I was like,
Yeah. And we had to like double check that because we're like, okay, hold on a second. Like, you know, we can't hype ourselves up, but like we gotta make sure. We heard him say like one official like sentence, and we're both like melting in our seats, like, oh. Dude,
I was done. Oh my god. I at that point I knew this movie is gonna be flames. Because anything that he's involved with is straight fire, and guess what? The theme was fire. So it was literally volcanoes the entire film. But it doesn't stop there. What's the soundtrack composer?
I don't know, but I'm pretty sure that, you know, like 85-90% of the music was all composed by a godlike composer. What was his name? Hiroyuki Sawano.
AKA, for those that are not up to date with your composers or people that are relevant to life itself, this is the same dude that writes the music for Attack on Titan. Did it for Promare 2. The movie was about 2 hours long. We literally got to hear fresh Sawano soundtrack greatness throughout the entire picture.
I've been listening to his music for so long, even before Attack on Titan, and like just an amazing composer at its finest. It's like you said, we were talking about it in the car before because we were a little ahead of ourselves. You said it yourself. Anything this man writes is not trash. Like, everything he writes is amazing. It's crazy.
But
like,
you had the best pun, please.
They said, first I wanna point to after the movie. We stayed after the movie because we not some leaving type of people. We stayed.
Never. Marvel taught me that.
They had a little interview. I don't know if those are the like some of the producers or writers.
Oh yeah, the director and like all that kind
of
stuff. Yeah.
So they had some of those people talking about the movie at the end of the movie, and they mentioned that Hiroyuki Sawano's music holds the same power that the visuals do. And I was like, that is straight facts.
I went like this.
Animation really helps bring things to life. Because, like, you know, you can really love something, especially, like, in manga, too. Like, you can absolutely, like, be beside yourself when you read that stuff. But when you see it animated, that shit brings it to life. When you hear people's voices or, like, some people are, like, super hyped. Manga readers are super hyped up about, like, hair colors. So, like, when you see, like, a character's hair color, some things like that. Just small things like that get you hyped up, bro. And then my statement was, Johnny Young Bosch's voice acting is the same as Hiroyuki Sawano's composing. Godlike. Nobody comes close to them. They are just at the top of their works, and they just get you invested in whatever they are doing.
He said this while I was driving. He almost killed us.
Yeah, he's like, you need to say that again. He's
like, I said, you need to hold that and say that for this.
Yeah, Johnny Young Bosch to voice acting is the same as Hiroyuki Sawano is to music composing. And they're just beyond their...
Fire.
Beyond. They break their limits. Flames. They break all of our limits.
Flames. Volcanoes. Eruptions. Earthquakes.
And I heard a couple. Destruction. Like, I heard like three voice actors that were really prominent flares. in my anime watching and dub watching. And they're all fire. Like, they hired some big voice actors for this. Like, it was really fucking good. The music.
Not even to discredit any of the voice actors that was in part of this film, but literally, like, I the only person I obviously have a connection with is Johnny. And as soon as I heard him, I honestly was like, it doesn't even matter who's on his cast. And I did recognize other voices just like you did. Like, they have Yuri Lowenthal's in there too. I don't remember who exactly he played, but look.
You hear the voice, you know.
Johnny is my dude. And I said it. I was like, yo. If he's in his film, it's over.
He did. He fucking called it. Because he said that to me while we were watching the movie. Like, towards the beginning of the movie, he was like, yo, if Johnny's in this, I'm done. I was just like, man, stop. I was like, you already know.
He's the coolest character.
And then they whoop out the character. We're both like, no. No fucking way. Like, he called it. He called it. And then, we were listening to some of the music. He was like, oh, this is Hiroyuki. I was like,
oh, my God. I knew there's no way this is not Sawano. We called
that shit at the same time with the music. I listened to way too much. I was like, that is definitely him.
Sawano just has a distinctive sound to what he composes.
It's not even a sound. It's a spirit. Like, that shit lifts you up. Like, you hear his music and you just start getting like chills and goosebumps. Like, you just start like, you lean in a little bit closer to watch the show. Like, everything around you just fades.
We got 1 minute.
That shit was fire.
All in all, from top to bottom, the story was very good. Super. It was deep. The animation was unique. in itself.
Yeah, it was. It was very unique. I'm going to be honest. I didn't really like it at first, but I kind of grew into it.
Yeah, I got to grow into it too.
Yeah, I kind of grew into it, and it was actually, it was really well done.
It was different, and they actually explained that at the end of the film. So, I mean, at the time of this recording, I don't really know if that's, like, the film's going to be available to watch. But, I mean, you never know. And I will say this, it will definitely most likely, what we're talking about, like the director's like comments or whatever that we saw like directly after within the theater, they even say, like, I'm sure it's going to be included in like the Blu-ray release whenever that comes out, because I am,
oh my god,
buying the shit out of that.
And like, yeah, the soundtracks, as in plural, like Hiroyuki just tore it up. He tore it all up. That was amazing. Yeah, everything about it was amazing. Animation, music, voice acting, done. Storyline, done. Go watch it. Check it out whenever you get the chance.
Damn. And with that, I will say this. Oh, wait. Oh, not repeat. Done. I will leave you guys with this. We didn't spoil everything, and that's a good thing, because there are parts that happen within the film that
you got to go check it out for yourself.
That just make it so... And it's very visually pleasing, and everything about
that's
it.
That's pretty true.
The aesthetic of the film, the theme, the soundtrack, everything was godlike. The voice cast was godlike. We literally, like I said, we just got back from the theater.
We walked in the door and got on the mics.
Yeah. So I hope you guys enjoyed this Full Power Extra. We'll probably use this as a way to talk about other shit.
Probably a lot more often than, but I like the whole 10-minute idea. I like just
10
like
minutes,
keeping
done.
It like 10 minutes.
Yeah. It's quick, it's rapid, we get our thoughts out there, quick review, and we say enough to, I'm sure, to get people interested, for sure. Because, dude, we wear our emotions on our fucking
wrists. If you
wrists.
Hear all of this and you're still not interested, you got us fucked up.
Dude, we was probably the loudest ones in there.
We were the loudest ones in there. We stayed, we were reading like the credits. Waiting for the credits to roll, and we see some names, and we see some...
As soon as we saw Johnny Young Bosch.
Just screaming.
Oh, we saw music composed by Hiroyuki Sawano.
It's not like we didn't know already, but we just wanted that visual confirmation.
And you told me not to look it up while I was watching it. Like, because you're like, no, we got to wait. Got to wait.
Because I told you straight up, when it came to things like Johnny and Hiroyuki, we both knew, like, we were both so far beyond sure. There was absolutely 100%. No need to look that shit up. We knew. We knew. There was no doubt in either
sure,
of our minds.
He made sure my
faith
was intact.
Don't look it up. Don't look it up. We know.
That's facts. All right. Well, with that all being said, guys, y'all know the drill. Like, share, subscribe, hit me up on Twitter, all that good stuff. Description. Well, the links are going to be in the description below. So please go ahead and support the channel in any and all ways that you possibly can. Support my man, Kai. He is literally the co-host of anything Full Power related. And you're going to see his ass way more on this channel, you know, especially now that we're doing this extra shit. Full Power extra.
We're still out of control.
Oh, yeah. Still. And then some. But, you know... Like, share, subscribe. I already said that. Keep it locked, loaded right here on Uchi Games channel. Stay classy. Take care of yourselves. May the power protect you. Don't have too much popcorn. And we'll see y'all.
The price of this popcorn was out of control.
Next time.